Hi, I'm Pavan Bakshi, CEO of Prime Meridian Consulting and an I4 NeuroLeader Certified Practitioner. The purpose of this presentation is to provide you with a deeper understanding of the I4 NeuroLeader program. With today's advancements in the neuroscience field, we now have evidence of certain brain processes that can help us better understand how we function as human beings. This new understanding is changing how we need to look at leadership and leadership development in the years to come. We need to move from a leader to a neuroleader. A neuroleader understands how their brain functions and knows how to optimize its performance to adapt to the fast-paced environment we are all living in. The era we are transitioning into is the imagination age, where ideas equals power. In an ideas economy, cultivating our own leadership is key. How we live and work has evolved. It is hence time to adapt. Leading in the information age requires a different set of abilities. Abilities that fit better with this new era of work. The I4 NeuroLeader model will help you focus on the leadership competencies needed to thrive in the 21st century. Move into understanding how leadership has evolved. This slide is a great comparison of the different eras we have lived through and are moving towards. We have moved from the industrial age, where control equaled power. However, the manager was important. Many organizational leaders still behave as if they are living in this era. Next, we move to the information age, where knowledge equaled power and leadership became important. It was more about we rather than I. As discussed earlier, the era we are transitioning into is the imagination age, where ideas equal power. We are now starting to understand how an integrated and optimized brain and body results in high potential at work and in life. We need to develop the brain behind the leader and teach strategies that can minimize stress, anxiety, and depression, among others, that can affect productivity and engagement. This model is also relevant in the VUCA world we live in. Leaders are no longer the figureheads guiding the delivery of predictable and stable business processes. They now have to lead when they do not know how. We now have the exciting opportunity to grow ourselves to be leaders for this VUCA world. To navigate the transition from leader to neuroleader, we must learn leadership through the lenses of neuroscience. To deal effectively with volatile conditions, we need imagination. Imagination is the faculty of mentally forming new concepts, ideas, or patterns without involving the senses. Imagination only happens inside our brain when we cut off the input from the external environment. To manage uncertainty, we need inspiration. Inspiration refers to the energy, enthusiasm, and desire to act as a result of feeling mentally and emotionally stimulated. The complexity of our business world needs our brain to work in an integrated way. Hence, integration is the key. Integration refers to the effective functioning of various components of the brain and body that result in a healthy system. To resolve ambiguity, we need to be able to tap into our intuition. Intuition refers to the ability to know something without the involvement of conscious reasoning. In the past 15 years, there has been little advancement in reshaping traditional leadership models. Leadership models are useful to help leaders and organizations focus on the behaviors that matter in order to make a business profitable and sustainable. Imagine if the people you work with could be the best they could be, a collaborative group with the time to think strategically and creatively about how you are going to reach your goals and propel your business forward in the imagination age. To us, it seemed natural to include the brain in a leadership model. The good news is that leadership skills can be learned by anyone in an organization, not just by the people at the top. The brain has plasticity and can remodel itself. Hence, our behaviors can change, irrespective of the position we are in. The point of difference between this model and others is that it is holistic. It focuses on becoming aware of and enhancing capabilities of the brain, body, and mind. The IFOR model is a personal leadership and well-being model which includes four key competencies: performance, collaboration, innovation, and agility. It is a model that incorporates the latest advancements from neuroscience to understand a leader's brain and subsequent behaviors. You can see each competency is made out of four pillars totaling 16. The first pillar for each competency is an I word describing a brain or bodily process, hence the term IFOR. Abilities such as brain integration, inspiration, imagination, and intuition have a biological basis, and we have not acknowledged or used these abilities in leadership development in the past. The IFOR model is also made up of other pillars such as generosity, adaptability, awareness, mental readiness that, if nurtured, can result in a more well-rounded and effective leader. Normally do not talk about what the brain can do, but people certainly appraise us based on most of the behaviors that originate in the brain. People will say he's a quick thinker or not, he's tolerant, diligent, determined, etc. All these behaviors originate in our brains, and they may vary according to how well or not the brain is working. Brain is at the core of what we do. When it works well, we feel good and are perceived positively by others. In the fast-paced life that we live in, we need to nurture our brain and body. Leadership is achievable and sustainable only when we have a healthy brain and mind in a healthy body. Start with performance. Brains need to be balanced for optimal performance. If the brain is not balanced, it affects our behaviors. How do you feel when you are performing at your best? You are present, have good judgment, are able to think for others, and can deal with pressure. You are in a state of flow or peak experience, totally immersed in what you are doing. How can we be collaborative? Inspiration is a critical aspect of collaboration, since it is like an invisible energy that mobilizes people into action. Courage and generosity will make people want to work with you willingly and be ready to go the extra mile. Innovation has become one of the most important strategic imperatives for organizations throughout the world. The power to imagine is critical, and the potential exists within all of us. However, without understanding how imagination and creativity works in the brain, we cannot be innovative. Agility has indisputably become one of the prime competencies to develop. We are living and leading in a complex world where uncertainty and change is a constant factor. Being agile can help people anticipate and solve issues that appear often in a rapidly changing environment. Knowing how to tap into our intuition, awareness, influence, and adaptability enables us to become more agile. See, how would the journey to become a neuro leader look like? We will start off with a 2-hour introduction session to give you an overview and better understanding of the journey. You will then take a 360 degree or individual or self-assessment based on your comfort level. This will be followed by a workshop and debrief of your assessment. Team exploration is an optional step. After this comes the post-survey or assessment phase, which I call the post-awareness phase. John Mitton, one of my mentors and also the coach of Steve Jobs, articulates this beautifully when he says, "Prescription without diagnosis is malpractice." Participants then work on improving performance, collaboration, innovation, and agility along with the coaching call. Each step should take around a month to complete. This is followed by a project, which is then documented in a case study. The entire journey closes with a 360 degree or self-assessment. This journey is also customized based on the specific needs of the organization. The I4 tool is a fully automated system where you can assess, track, and quantify your development from your very own dashboard. There are 30,000 neuroscientists working around the world, researching the brain and publishing findings. The questions that are in the I4 assessment have come from neuroscience research, Sylvia's experience in leadership development, many focus groups, interviews with managers and leaders from all over the world that form part of her research. It is from a neurological basis, not a psychological base, like other tools. The assessment measures elements of performance that no other tool does, because the brain was taken into account when developing the assessment. There is more evidence now about how the brain works than what there was when many other leadership or personality tools were developed. With the emergence of brain science, there is enough evidence to suggest that the brain has a lot more to do with reshaping behavior than we may have originally thought. Once we understand how the brain works in its optimal state, then we can start looking at behaviors and culture through different lenses and utilize effective and leading edge models and frameworks different to those we have used in the past. This new understanding of how we best function is here to stay. The sooner we embrace it and share it with others, the healthier the collective will be. At the About My Brain Institute, we like to use the term brain-friendly culture, which can be applied to an organization. Such an entity aims to improve the performance of all the brains working within it in order to increase business productivity and employees' well-being and engagement. Creating a brain-friendly workplace where employees' brains can offer their best thinking is what will differentiate the best organizations from the average ones in the years to come. Thank you for joining me in this presentation. I'm sure you would have found it useful. For any further information or clarifications, please feel free to reach out to me at my email address given here.